Henoch Schonlein Purpura. The primary objectives are to review the classification criteria and other clinical manifestations of Henoch Schonlein Purpura, as well as to review its current therapeutic options and potential outcomes. The presentation outline includes diagnostic criteria, epidemiology and pathogenesis, clinical manifestations, ancillary studies, treatment and prognosis of Henoch Schonlein purpura. Henoch Schonlein purpura, or HSP, is the most common systemic vasculitis of childhood and is characterized by a tetrad of clinical manifestations: non-thrombocytopenic palpable purpura, arthritis and arthralgia, abdominal pain, and renal disease. It is an immune-mediated vasculitis associated with immunoglobulin A or IgA deposition. The most recent classification criteria are those of the European League Against Rheumatism and Pediatric Rheumatology European Society, published in 2006. The criteria for HSP include a mandatory finding of palpable purpura or petechiae with lower limb predominance and without thrombocytopenia, in addition to one or more of the following: diffuse abdominal pain, arthritis or arthralgia, renal involvement, and or a biopsy specimen demonstrating predominant IgA deposition. HSP is predominantly a small vessel vasculitis. The photograph on this slide shows a patient's legs covered by slightly raised, palpable purpuric lesions that are characteristic of HSP. Approximately 90% of HSP cases occur in children, with a peak age of onset between 3 and 10 years. Its incidence is estimated at 14 to 20 per 100,000 children per year, and it affects males slightly more frequently than females, specifically 1.2 to 1.8 males affected per one female. HSP is unusual in the summer months, and many cases can follow an upper respiratory infection. The exact pathogenesis of HSP remains unknown, though an infectious trigger is suspected given the frequency of preceding upper respiratory infections, particularly with group A beta hemolytic streptococcus. HSP occasionally clusters in families, suggesting a genetic component. HSP is an immune-mediated vasculitis associated with IgA deposition, and there is an interest in better understanding the role of IgA immune complexes in the pathogenesis of HSP. Disorders of coagulation have also been associated with the development of HSP. The hallmark of HSP is its rash. Palpable purpura typically start as pink macules or wheals and develop into larger purpura. Occasionally, bulli and ulcerations develop, as illustrated by these pictures. The skin lesions are usually symmetric and have a predilection for the lower extremities or gravity-dependent areas. They also tend to appear in crops and may recur up to 4 months after their initial presentation. Gastrointestinal manifestations can occur in up to 80% of children with HSP and range from mild to more significant findings. Mild symptoms include nausea, vomiting, and abdominal pain. The most common significant GI complication is intussusception, but others include hemorrhage, bowel ischemia, and perforation. Endoscopic evaluation may identify purpura and vasculitis of the intestinal tract, as illustrated in this picture. Musculoskeletal involvement, including arthritis and arthralgia, is also common and may occur in up to 75% of children with HSP. The arthritis is usually oligoarticular and mainly affects the lower limb joints. It also tends to be self-limited, typically resolving within 2 weeks. Neurologic manifestations are less common and may be secondary to elevated blood pressures or central nervous system vasculitis. Localized subcutaneous edema is also common, as illustrated by this picture of scrotal swelling. Other potentially affected areas include the dorsa of the hands and feet, periorbital area, lips, and scalp. Other less common manifestations of HSP include orchitis, carditis, inflammatory eye disease, testicular torsion, and pulmonary hemorrhage. The renal disease of HSP deserves special discussion since it is probably the most significant determinant of long-term outcome. Renal disease occurs in up to 50% of children with HSP. Renal involvement may present with a wide spectrum of abnormalities, from asymptomatic protein or blood in the urine to less common nephrotic syndrome, acute nephritic syndrome, hypertension, or renal failure. Renal disease is mediated by the deposition of IgA in the glomeruli. Most patients who develop renal disease will do so within 3 months after symptom onset. It rarely occurs before the rash. Patients suspected of having more severe renal involvement may require biopsy, as the severity of the lesion may guide treatment and is the primary determinant of prognosis. Renal histopathology typically shows mesangial proliferation with hypercellularity. There may be a focal segmental process or extensive crescentic involvement, indicating more significant inflammatory damage. Like in other tissues, immunostaining for IgA deposition is positive, as in this photomicrograph. Most kidney disease resolves spontaneously, but a small minority of patients may experience either recurrence or persistence. Progression to end-stage renal disease is uncommon, occurring in only 1 to 2% of children. The diagnosis of HSP is a clinical one, and the classification criteria previously discussed may help with the diagnosis. There are no diagnostic laboratory abnormalities for making the diagnosis of HSP. Patients may have elevated white blood cell and platelet counts and elevated acute phase reactants. Occult blood is frequently found in stool specimens. Testing for autoantibodies is not useful except to exclude other disease. And anti-neutrophil cytoplasmic antibodies, or ANCAs, associated with other vasculitides are typically absent. If one suspects HSP, evaluation for renal involvement by measuring blood pressures, urinalyses, and serum creatinine is absolutely necessary. There is also evidence that serum von Willebrand factor antigen levels may be elevated and may correlate with HSP disease severity. Imaging studies are usually performed in patients with significant abdominal symptoms, and modalities used include radiographs to evaluate for GI perforation, ultrasounds to evaluate for intussusception or bowel wall thickening, or CT for more severe GI involvement, such as small bowel wall thickening shown in this CT image. Biopsies of the skin and kidney may be warranted in patients with incomplete or unusual presentations. They characteristically show IgA deposition, as previously discussed. Immunofluorescent staining of biopsy specimens reveal IgA deposition in the walls of small vessels of all tissues, as in this photomicrograph of a lesional skin biopsy. Skin biopsies demonstrate vasculitis of the dermal capillaries and post-capillary venules. The inflammatory infiltrate includes neutrophils and monocytes. Treatment is primarily supportive, with maintenance of adequate hydration and nutrition and control of pain with analgesics, specifically non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. The early use of glucocorticoids in HSP is controversial, though there are reports of its benefit in shortening the duration of abdominal symptoms and in preventing GI complications. There is no conclusive evidence that glucocorticoids can prevent the onset of HSP renal disease. Severe and chronic HSP renal disease may require treatment with various immunosuppressants in conjunction with glucocorticoid therapy. Renal transplantation has been successful in some children who develop renal failure. HSP is typically self-limited and the prognosis is excellent. Approximately 30% of children with HSP will experience recurrence, although these episodes are generally less symptomatic and of shorter duration. Children with a more severe initial course are at higher risk for relapse. The primary long-term complication is renal disease. Therefore, recommended follow-up includes follow-up urinalyses and blood pressure checks once every 1 to 2 weeks for the first 2 months after the onset of symptoms, and then once every 1 to 2 months for the remaining year after the onset of symptoms. Chronic kidney disease develops in 1 to 2% of children with HSP. In summary, HSP is the most common vasculitis of childhood, and it is predominantly a small vessel vasculitis associated with IgA deposition. The diagnosis is clinical, including its Hallmark rash. Prognosis is excellent in most cases. Key references.